Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. Today I have a new topic, which is like how to answer introduce yourself question when you have like prior work experience, right? So I made this video for only 2 to 8 years of experienced candidate. This will not be useful for freshers or people who has more than 10 years of experience, right? So let's get into the video. But before that, we are doing our best to bring new content every week, so please subscribe to our channel and share across social media sites, and comment if you have any suggestions, questions, things like that, right? So yeah, without any further ado, let's get into our topic. So basically, whenever you attend interview, right, this is the first question every interviewer will ask you, so that he can like he can find some time to go through your resume. So if you are experienced person, definitely he will expect you should talk about your prior experiences. If you have more than one experience, I mean, if you worked on more than one project, or if you worked in more than one company, then you should talk about your recent experience, I mean immediate past company. And so first thing is you have to start with years of work experience, and then overall technologies you touch in your career basically. So how much experience you have and what are the technologies you touched in your career, and recently like what are the active technologies you're working on. So once this is like, you know, overall picture of who you are. So once experience part is completed, then you should talk about immediate past work experience. Like you should talk about the project you worked on, and the company name, and team size, etc. Once that is completed, and what was your previous project developed on? So what are all the technologies your team or your company used to develop that product, right? And then what are all the technologies you are learning or you learned during that period. So these are the two things you have to talk about first. Mostly many people start introduce yourself question as with their personal name and with their family details, so that won't be necessary. So I would suggest against doing that, because once he has resume, right, so he basically go through that, he will come to know your name and your personal details, right? You don't have to tell him explicitly. And then once past experience is done, then you talk about your project. So recent project, and what was the project built on, as I said, right? So once you explained about technologies used in that project, then you should talk about architecture of that project, and what are all the interesting learning you did during that work tenure, right? So, and who are the users, internal users or external users or general public, so you should explain that as well. So, and if you have faced any challenges, and this is the right time to talk about, right? So once you gave overall description about your project, then you should talk about the challenges. One or two challenges you should prepare before interview, so that it will be helpful. So once you come to this section, so you talk about challenges, at least one or two. So like what are the challenges you faced, and how you or your team, it's not necessarily solved by you, even your team also, if any issue solved, you can talk about that. But make sure you mention your involvement during that, like you help do solving that challenge, something like that. Excuse me. So once that is done, you should talk about achievements and awards. So basically, what are all the achievements? You might have got some client appreciations or your manager appreciations, something like that. And then you might have like people might have nominated you for a CEO award or monthly star awards, right? So quarterly awards. So you can talk about those things, one or two lines. And then once that is completed, still interviewer is expecting like more information by this point, then you can talk about any other experiences you have. Like you worked on two companies, so far we talked about only one company. So now this is the time to talk about your first company, I can say. Or if you worked on three companies, then you should talk about other two companies. So something like that. But once that is completed, then you come to personal information. So here, as I said, right, so we don't have to talk about our personal information, but you can mention one or two points, like from where you hail and where you settled and why you are looking for a job in that city which you are attending interview, right? So that you can talk about, but not about family and siblings, those things. But mostly by this time, like fourth point, right? So people will interrupt and they start asking about your project or some technical questions, if it is a technical interview. So why this is useful for only 2 to 8 years of experience? Because basically freshers, they don't have experience, prior experience, right? So they might have worked on the academic project, they can explain about that project, but they don't have any real-time experience. That's why they cannot talk about prior experiences. So that's the reason I mentioned 2 to 8 years experience. And once that is completed, I'm talking about freshers, right? So once they talked about their academic project, they can talk about the technologies they learned recently and they're interested to what are the frameworks they're interested to learn. So they can talk about that, but I'll make another video separately for only freshers, because I cannot put all those things in here, right? So, and if you have more than 8 years of experience, let's say you have 10 years experience, and you might have switched between like two to three companies. So by 10 years, right, you must be in a leadership role, a team lead or a project lead or a module lead or might be manager, right? So talking about technical things as a manager is not good. So as a team lead, you should talk about what are the project you handle and what are the team strength you handle and what are the challenges you face during those times, right? So you should talk about those. What are all the interesting process changes you brought into company? So these things you should talk about if you have more than like 8 years experience, right? So yeah, that's it for today. Please let me know if you have any a different view other than this. Like you might have prepared a different structure, right? So let me know. If you want to suggest any other thing, that's also fine. Please comment below, and thank you.